गुड मॉर्निंग माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न टूडे लुईस डॉट स्ट्रक्चर ट्रिक्स, विच इज़ वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक रिलेटेड टू योर स्कूल एग्जाम्स. लाइक इफ यू आर आस्क्ड अबाउट राइट द लुईस डॉट स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ अमोनियामाइन, देन हाउ यू आर गोइंग टू राइट इट. सो दिस इज गिवन बाय लुईस थ्योरी. लुईस थ्योरी एक्सप्लेन्स कोवेलेंट बॉन्ड फॉर्मेशन. एंड इफ यू आर कन्फ्यूज्ड वाइल राइटिंग द स्ट्रक्चर, व्हाट शुड बी द सेंट्रल एटम, व्हाट शुड बी द कॉर्नर एटम, सो हेयर आर सम रूल्स टू डिसाइड what can be the central atom and if you are given a number of atoms. So the rule number one for deciding the central atom, it should be present in the least number, or its electronegativity should be the least, or its size can be the largest, or its atomic number is the largest. So next, hydrogen and fluorine can't be central atom ever. Corner atom octet should be complete. For the central atom, octet rule can be broken. It can have 8 or more than 8 electrons. And very important rule, central atom tries to always remain maximum covalency. Like for oxygen, it is 2, sulfur for 6, nitrogen 5. Yeah, it can make maximum bond 4. Phosphorus 5 covalency and carbon maintains 4 covalency. And while writing the Lewis dot structure and you are going to put positive charge, where to put it? It is always added on the central atom. And what about the negative charge? Where we need to put while writing the Lewis dot structure? It is always added on the corner atom. So these are the rules to decide the central atom. Next is the calculation part. So what is the calculation? Like if we are going to write the ammonium Lewis dot structure, we have to first find out the total number of valence electrons in it. Okay, like for nitrogen, their atomic number is 7 and the outermost orbit electronic configuration 2, 5. So 5 is its valence electron. For hydrogen, it's only having one electron, so that is going to be its valence electron. And you are having 4 hydrogen here, so total number of valence electron is going to be 5 plus 4, that is 9. So if you are given the positive charge on it, positive charge means one electron is lost from it. What you are going to do, you are going to reduce one number from the total valence electron. Like for ammonium, there are total 9 valence electrons, but it is having positive charge, means you are going to remove one electron from the total number of valence electrons. So the electrons present in this particular molecule is 8. But if there is a negative charge on any molecule, like nitrite ion, NO3-, nitrate ion, what is going to be the valence electrons total here? For nitrogen, the valence electron is 5. For oxygen, atomic number is 8. So electronic configuration is 2, 6. There are 3 atoms total. So 6 into 3. And one electron we are going to subtract from it. So this is going to be 5 plus 18 minus 1. So this is going to give you the total number of valence electrons present in it. So what we did, we reduced one positive charge. If there is positive charge, we have to subtract that charge from the total valence electron. If there is a negative charge, we have to add that number in the total valence electron. Next is bond pairs. Bond pair electrons. You have to find out how many bonds are present and then you multiply it with 2. And how to find out lone pair? Total valence electrons minus bond pair electrons. You are going to get lone pairs. And what we are going to do lone pair? First, you have to arrange all the lone pairs on the corner atoms. The remaining you are going to give it to the central atom. And if still there are pending lone pair to be distributed, you are going to create a double or triple bond. That I will explain you during the practice. So let's start how to draw the Lewis structure for nitrate ion NO3-. What we are going to do, first you have to find out nitrogen 5 valence electrons. For oxygen, atomic number oxygen is 8, so electronic configuration 2, 6, so 6 is the valence electron, 6 into 3. What I had told you already, minus. Okay, so you are going to add one electron into it. So 6, 3 is 18, 18 plus 1, 19, 19 plus 5, that is going to be 24. Now next, bond pair electrons. Okay, while calculating bond pair electrons, what you are going to do, nitrogen is the central atom. Okay, and because it is present in the least number. And the next is you are going to write down oxygen. There are three oxygens, so I have written like this. Now the next job, how many bond here? 1, 2, 3. So there are 3, and I am going to multiply it with 2, so there are 6 bond electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, now the lone pair electrons, what to do for the lone pair electrons? You are going to subtract 24 minus 6, and that is going to be equal to 18. These 18 electrons you have to distribute to the central atom first. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. So all the lone pair electrons are distributed to the corner atoms. Now there is one problem. You have to decide, like, nitrogen always maintain covalency of 5. Now what to do? Now your nitrogen will ask this oxygen to share its lone pair. This lone pair will shift towards this. You can even show this bond going to this side or this bond going to this side. So your structure now will turn out to be like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So here is the structure. Now where to put the negative sign? See, bacho, the negative sign can be decided by the formal charge calculation, which I will share with you in the next video. So as for now, I can tell you the negative charge can be added to this oxygen or it can be added to this oxygen. You can never give to this negative charge to this oxygen, because this oxygen is having formal charge 0. So this is how you are going to write down the Lewis structure of NO3 minus.